Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat siang Bapak Ibu di webinar mengenai How to Find Novelty in Research. Jadi workshop ini, webinar ini diselenggarakan oleh Akademi Farmasi YPPM Mandiri Banda Aceh. Di sini keynote speakernya Asoprof Dr. Muzamil bin Jusoh. Beliau adalah pensyarah dosen dari University Malaysia Perlis School of Computer and Communication Engineering. Nah, untuk pembuka pertama saya berikan kepada Ibu Rosa Mardiana untuk memberikan opening speech kegiatan siang ini. Saya kasih kepada Ibu Rosa, silahkan.
Oke, terima kasih Pak Robi. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ada jelas suara saya?
Jelas, Ibu.
Oke, terima kasih. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Puji syukur kehadirat Allah Subhanahu wa taala yang telah memberikan kita nikmat sehat pada kita semua sehingga kita bisa melangsungkan acara seminar internasional pada hari ini. Salawat dan salam kita sanjungkan kepada Nabi besar Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam yang telah membawa kita dari alam kebodohan ke alam yang penuh ilmu pengetahuan seperti yang kita rasakan sekarang. Oke, terima kasih saya ucapkan kepada para peserta yang telah bergabung di acara seminar ini. Kita mengundang pemateri dari Malaysia yaitu Associate Profesor Dr. Zamil bin Jusoh dari University Malaysia Perlis ya, seperti yang dibilang sama Pak Ruby tadi sebagai moderator. Oke, dengan tema How to Find Novelty in Research. Bagaimana kita menemukan hal-hal baru atau hal-hal yang istimewa dalam suatu penelitian. Dan itu nanti yang akan dipaparkan oleh pemateri kita pada hari ini. Saya harapkan kepada para peserta, dosen-dosen yang mungkin telah berhadir, bisa menyimak dengan seksama, karena apa? Ini penting sekali bagi kita, pengajar atau dosen yang mengabdi pada suatu perguruan tinggi ya. Seperti yang kita ketahui bersama, menjadi seorang dosen itu kita wajib untuk melakukan tridharma perguruan tinggi. Salah satunya ya penelitian ini. Oke. Dan ini nanti akan dipaparkan juga oleh pemateri kita yang sangat berpengalaman mungkin ya. Yang saya harapkan juga mungkin saya ada pernah mendengar dosen-dosen baru mereka yang belum melakukan penelitian walaupun dia telah mengajar di suatu perguruan tinggi tapi belum melakukan sebuah penelitian, suatu penelitian atau pengabdian masyarakat. Nah, mungkin ini mereka masih bingung bagaimana sih caranya menemukan hal-hal yang baru yang akan kita teliti. Sebenarnya mungkin simple kalau untuk dari apa lingkungan kita sendiri. Yang pertama mungkin kita mengamati bagaimana fenomena yang terjadi di lingkungan kita ya. Ya seperti sekarang ini mungkin COVID ya itu bisa kita angkat juga menjadi sebuah artikel atau suatu penelitian. Banyak sebenarnya. Kemudian kita temukan permasalahannya apa, kemudian kita didukung juga oleh berbagai jurnal artikel yang sudah ada. Ya, mungkin nanti lebih lanjutnya saya serahkan kepada para pemateri dan moderator. Saya harapkan seminar ini berjalan dengan lancar dan ilmu yang kita dapatkan bisa bermanfaat dan berkah. Sekian saja Pak Robi, sambutan dari saya. Kurang lebih saya mohon maaf. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, terima kasih Ibu Rosa atas sambutannya. Berikutnya kita langsung saja, saya persilahkan kepada Asoprof Dr. Muzamil untuk memberikan materi mengenai how to find novelty in research. Dokter, boleh sampaikan dalam bahasa Inggris, Melayu, boleh mix bebas, nanti kalau apa saya boleh bantu translate. Silakan dokter. Suara dokter, saya tidak kedengaran.
Okey, terima kasih Ruby, terima kasih Ibu Rosa. So, saya Muzammil daripada Universiti Malaysia Perlis. Sorry, saya dalam restoran juga macam Pak Ruby. Ada acara. So, terima kasih kepada Pak Mesran dan juga rakan-rakan di Indonesia. InsyaAllah, saya akan kongsikan sebaik mungkin berkaitan dengan tajuk hari ini. So, sekarang saya share slide. Boleh saya share slide? Hello,
Pak Ruby. Silakan, silakan.
Boleh, boleh, boleh. Sekejap, sekejap. Okey, sebentar ya.
Okey. Lama tak jumpa Pak Mesra ni.
Okey, silakan. Silakan, doktor. Boleh slide.
Alright. Okey, nampak ya?
Okey, nampak.
Okay. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So hari ini kita lebih kepada sharing lah. Saya suka guna konsep sharing. It's more like lebih dekat lah, lebih dekat. Sebab yang saya pasti di sana, rakan-rakan di sana pun dozen-dozen sama macam saya. So kita akan sharing today is about how to find novelty in research. Okay, saya Muzammil. Saya juga research fellow di Advanced Communication Engineering as Center of Excellence, School of Computer and Communication Engineering, Universiti Malaysia Perlis. Selain itu, saya juga menjawat jawatan Director of Student Development and Services Center di UMAP. So, sedikit pasal saya lah. Saya buat PhD pada tahun 2011 hingga 2013 and then saya Master pada 2009 hingga 2010, Bachelor 2002 hingga 2006. So, my research expertise is more on reconfigurable antenna using RF switches, UWB, MIMO and wearable application. Even recently, kita baru publish dekat PLOS One macam mana kita integrate between the UWB communication dan juga AI technologies. So, we come up dengan breast cancer action system. So, ini kita telah publish dalam PLOS One. Semalam baru dapat acceptance. And then, there's experience working. Previously, I did join Telecom Malaysia for 3 years sebelum saya masuk UNIMAP. Before that, saya involved dengan MTK Communication. So, all is about communication. So, my H index is 15. Then, saya ada 179 papers. Citation, kalau Scopus, 823. And then, kalau Google Scholar pun quite okay. This one is updated 15 June lah. Okay. Apa yang saya sharing ni actually related to novelty. Because when come to novelty, is about research, and when talk about research, of course we talk about student supervision. Student supervision. Macam kita sebagai dozen, kita ada student degree, ada student masters, and then kita student yang PhD. So it is our compulsory and it is our role actually to find the novelty for our students. Dulu pernah my dozen beritahu, actually, as a supervisor, what we have to do, actually, we have to know when we have to say stop. So, because when student, actually our masters, our PhD student, they got studies, it's like they just do their work. So, what we will do is we have to say to them, oh, ini cukup. This is enough for your masters. This is enough for your PhD. So, as a supervisor, you must have the guts to say and you must know how to say, oh, ini cukup. So, to say cukup actually based on your novelty and your contribution of the particular work. So, that's why novelty sangat-sangat penting. Okay, kalau sini saya sudah ada student PhD graduated, Alhamdulillah. Saya 4 graduated, main supervisor. And then untuk masters, saya sudah ada 2 dan 2 lagi ongoing. So, dari segi research topic, kalau tengok my students more on communication and computer. For example like this one, ini yang semalam baru publish, hybridization of K-fold with feed forward back propagation algorithm. For this one actually is integration between communication and also the computer parts. Actually communication is more on how kita nak extract the data set, do the setting and get the data set. So AI part actually to do the the tracking, and then we have to do the training, testing, and everything. So ni student saya, all of them, and then empat job master yang tengah berjalan. Okay, sedikit pasal tajuk hari ini. First, I will talk about UNIMAP, and then we go for what is research, novelty versus originality. So ini benda-benda penting yang kadang-kadang kita is a bit confused. Novelty, originality, innovation, invention. Fourth is about novelty research, and last one is conclusion. Sedikit pasal UNIMAP. This is the picture of UNIMAP lah. And then our motto is knowledge, sincerity, and excellence. So kepada yang masih belum datang ke UNIMAP, please come and be one of us lah. So actually UNIMAP start dengan college universities on May 2001, and then kita grow, and now we already becoming University Malaysia Perlis on 2007. Actually our students is almost 13,000. Nearly 10,000 is undergraduates. So this is our mission, vision, and core values lah. Okay, UNIMAP ada tiga main campuses. Actually the HQ is Pahu Putra. I think Robby will always be there. And then UniCity is near to Thailand area. Ni selalu kita makan pulut ayam lah, Robby. And then Kanga actually is more on the city campus. City campus where we cater a lot of international students is joining this center, joining this business and media, new media campus. Okay, about a little bit about achievement. UNIMAP achievement, actually kita telah dirankkan based on the World University Ranking Top 2020, top 800 on year 2020. We have been ranked third, equivalent to USM, UTM and others. So dari segi numbers, we are actually in pool 601 to 800. So that's where we are lah. Kalau kita tengok dari segi young universities, kita actually quite excellent. Even kalau kita tengok dari segi in Asian institution, we are number 165 from 489. This is some facilities that actually related to me lah, more related to my research work. This is about bioelectromagnetics, where we do on EEG, ECG, and so on. So this one is about specific absorption rate, also about the effect of the signal to the human body. And then this is some of works has been done before for my research group. Besides, kita pun ada buat point-to-point propagation, on-body communication. And then this is what I said just now, kita ada buat UWB-based classification of early breast detection system. Okay, this is the latest research grant that I have been secured lah. So ini yang kita kata tadi, now I did some studies on 5Gs, cognitive performance, well-being, psychological, just secure. This one actually from our Malaysian government, Malaysian Communication and Multimedia Commission. Saya pun, our team also has been studied on investigation of human skin dehydration detection using non-invasive optical sensing for medical application. So actually my passion is more on research. It's more on research. So when you want to do research, of course you will talk about contribution, novelty, because all this work actually will be carried on by our masters and so when talk about masters and PhD student, of course we talk about novelty, contribution. Okay, what is research? Okay, research is actually a careful study of an object. It's, some people say maybe this research is not for current, but actually for future. It's just all about research. That is research. Even kalau kita tengok in Germany, they give abbreviation. They give the question when they ask, what is the meaning of engineering or engineers? It's about problem solving. It's about research. It's a purposeful and systematic investigation. Third one is for understanding, and of course, it's about improving. Improvement. Journey of research. kalau kita tengok research ni from the beginning side, me when before I did my PhD also, all look nice. Everything look nice, very excellent, very nice. Actually, when you go for research, you have to nail it until this one. So before, you see like this, but if you cannot nail until this, what do you call it, until this level, you actually didn't do enough research. Same goes to like this. This is actually by plan. By plan, you will see, you will do this data acquisition, computer controller and prototype. But actually, when you do research, of course, it will look mess. You will see that you are actually really crack your head. That is the journey of research. That's why when we do PhD atau master, of course, only sekali dalam semua hidup. And then what you will experience, itulah experience yang sangat-sangat bermakna dalam hidup, which is you will never forget and you will never repeat. So never forget and you will never repeat. So that's why kalau you dah start buat master's or PhD, you have to nail it. You have to really focus on it. Okay, this is research is like this. Apa yang kita buat, kita takkan tahu apa yang we will get. So we will do, buat, sentiasa explore. At the end, what the most important thing is never give up. Because you will don't know, you would actually don't know what is actually waiting for you at the other side of the world. So kalau kita tengok gambar ini, buat dan terus buat. Don't give up. Because kalau kita tengok, actually very slimly, you akan achieve your goal. But if you give up, of course you will fail from the beginning. Okay, this is my drawing lah. Semalam saya ada draw sikit. So actually this drawing, I always draw this to all my postgrad students, my master or my PhD. So this is depth of knowledge. This is actually my summarization, what I understand based on what is the meaning of masters, what is the meaning of PhD, and what is the postgrad all about. So it's about depth of knowledge. And this is versus wide of knowledge. So wide of knowledge. Apa yang tuan-tuan nampak di sini, this is ada dua graf. Satu, deep, narrow down. Another one is very wide, but tak narrow. So actually your master's is this. This is your master's. Master's ni maksudnya, you will learn something very wide knowledge, but the depth of knowledge is not so deep. It's just like so-so, it's okay. So that is the master's. Master, you can learn macam-macam. That's why when you do a system, that one can be called as master's also. But kalau you buat PhD, system cannot be a PhD. So even though when people do IoT, what do you call? People do PhD in IoT. Actually, IoT is a system. They cannot be a PhD, but the security, for example, will be your PhD. Security is part of the IoT system, but that will be your PhD. So, for example like me, of course, that's why kalau kita tengok mana-mana doctors, mana-mana scholars, good scholars, for me, I will not say I am very good in all of field. So, I just know very narrow. So, this is what I understand only. This is depth but narrow. That is PhD. So people must understand. Kalau orang be so arrogant, so proud, actually nothing to proud of. You just know this part. So other people, other doctors, they know the other parts. So actually, why you becoming so arrogant? Just collaborate. Just collaborate and be humble. So to stress, masters, it has wide of knowledge, but depth of knowledge is not so deep. But PhD, it has narrow knowledge, but it's very deep. It's very deep. Means you will thoroughly discuss, thoroughly research, thoroughly check on that particular things. That's why people get confused. People get confused between complexity and continuity. Actually, it's supposed to be, for me, what I understand, PhD or masters, especially PhDs, is about continuity. It's not about complexity. Complexity means if you do a system, very big project, so that is the master's. But it's not a PhD. PhD, you must have continuity. That's why from your chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, your work is continuity. It's not like macam you do this work and then you do the other work which is not related, don't have any continuity. And then you do also the other work, don't have continuity, then you combine all of them becoming one PhD work. No, it's not a PhD. So this is still have some discussion lah based on the scholars. But what I do understand, PhD is about continuity from one to another. Okay, why research is needed? So this is what I understand lah, to inform on action, to establish a proof of theory, contribute to developing knowledge. To inform on action is a tool for building knowledge and for facilitating learning, to understand various issues and increase public awareness. This is important. That's why you see, I shown you just now, my recent research about 5G base station effects towards human being. So as you know, kita sekarang tengah move ke 5G technologies. So the importance for the cabinet, actually our parliament, to know the effect towards the effects of the 5G technology, 5G signal to the human being. So this is to increase, actually just to increase public awareness, because public, when they know after this we have 5G, before this we have 4G, what is the effect? Because kalau you tengok, since our population is increased, our cities also have been developed. So the base station, they install base station near to the schools, near to the taman-taman, near to the residential area. So the public awareness has been increased. That's why they want to know. That is the reason why we get a project. We approach the government and then the government pass the project to us. Maybe you can do so to the something to the Indonesian government also. Maybe they would like to know about this. If you want, then we can collaborate lah. Because we already done before effect of 4G to the public awareness, to the public effect. The one we already established and complete. So we move to 5G. Okay, secondly, it's about to establish or prove a theory. So of course, when you do a research, you just want to prove something. Either, for example, like now they talk about flying cars. So what they want to know, either this can happen or not. So that is the research. Besides, to an aid to business success. This is of course lah. Contribute to developing knowledge, nourish and exercise for the mind, a seat to love reading, writing, analyzing and sharing valuable information. This is very important. Because when you do research, you cannot run from this. Read, write, analyze and share. So it's very important. Share, it can be publication. That's why I go for Scopus, I go for a number of publications, actually just to share the knowledge. Means to find, gauge and seize opportunities, of course. This is the reason why we go to the conference. We meet people, same like this, we have a discussion, sharing. So just to find opportunities. Okay, how research is conducted? Research phase, define the problem, review the literature. Okay, when you talk about research, you must go for the problem statement. That's why dalam your thesis, even either master or PhD, kita ada chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4, 5. Chapter 1, we discuss about your intro, your objective. Besides, kita ada your problem statement. Before your objective, you must have your problem statement. Dalam introduction, you have your problem statement. So your problem statement, and then you go for objective to achieve the problem statement, to solve the problem statement. You need to have your objective. So that is the continuity. It must reflect. And then in the end, in result and discussion, your method is the method in your chapter 3 is a method whereby you want to know what is the method or technology that you want to use to achieve your objective. And your chapter 4 is about the result. You want to see either your result really reflect and achieve or successfully meet the target of your objective. Then you have your conclusion. So operationalize phase, you have the defined variables and measurement techniques, design experimental methods, then you have your data collection, of course you have data collection, statistical data analysis and discussion, and then communication of research output. So boleh dengar Ruby? I mean, anyone? Can you hear
me? Boleh. Okay. Suara okay.
Yeah. Okay, suara okay.
Suara okay, okay. So next we go for between novelty and originality. So this is the confused word, novelty and originality. It looks same. It looks same, very same. Novelty, sometimes people say, oh, original, of course, original is novel. But novel does, original means novel, but, sorry, novel means is original, of course, but original doesn't mean novel. So for example, original is anything that you create, that you inject new ideas, that is your original, your own. For example, you do start new setup, for example, like breast cancer detection. I'm doing breast cancer detection work currently. Kita dapat satu plus one just published yesterday. That setup, they pakai dua antena, dua receiver, transmitter and receiver, and then they have their RF module. So the setup use radar system. One to one, but you can do a new approach whereby you can have one transmitter and two receiver. So that is the original work, your work. But novelty, new novelty is a new methodology that achieve the technical goals, sometimes known as know-how. So dalam kita punya PhD or masters, novelty is very very important, especially on PhD. Kalau masters is still okay. For example, like masters, you do, I give example lah. You do a system, for example like baby tracking system is the system where you use the PCB board, you use the Raspberry Pi, and then you introduce the new, you use different board, for example SBC, single board chip, or you use other boards. Arduino and so on. So that is the originality. You just enhance a little bit. That can be considered as master's work. But novelty is more than that actually. That's why when you want to know either your work is really novel or not, you will do the comparison. That what we call as table comparison work of previous works. Later I will show you. Based on the previous work comparison, you will see, this is something that you can inject more in order for you to achieve the novelty. So later I will show you. Next slide. Okay, technology, this is the definition. In technology, novelty means it's derived from Latin words, novus, for new. It's new. It's the quality of being new, or following from that of being striking, original, or unusual. In social, it means shared experience of a new cultural phenomena or the subjective perception of an individual. This is the definition of technology and social for novelty. So return to technology. Actually, novelty is very close to innovation. Actually, you enhance the current work. Innovation is a new idea, more effective device or process. Innovation can be viewed as the application of better solutions that meet new requirements. So this is the keyword: better solutions that meet new requirements. Of course, when you do master's or PhD, what you want to do is you want to contribute. That's why sometimes people in their thesis, they will write a contribution. This is contribution. This is novelty. But mostly they will use this is contribution. So what is your contribution in this work? So of course it will give better solutions that meet new requirements in articulated needs or existing market needs. This is accomplished through more effective products, process, services, technology, or ideas that are readily available to markets, governments, and society. The term innovation can be defined as something original and more effective, and as a consequence, new that breaks into the market or society. So actually, novelty is very close to innovation. Innovation ni pula is differ from invention. Invention actually you create totally new things. New things, suddenly out of mind. For example, recently I watched one video, how they convert bicycle becoming motorboat. So that is the invention, the new technology. But innovation actually, you just enhance. Innovation refers to the use of a better and as a result, novel idea or method, whereas invention refers more directly to the creation of the idea or method itself. In pada tu, people also talk about innovation and improvement. It differs. In that innovation, it refers to the notion of doing something different. Okay, kalau kita tengok, innovation differ from improvement, di mana innovation refers to different rather than doing the same thing better. So that is the innovation. From there, it comes the contribution, and from there also, it has the novelty. Okay. Originality is the aspect of creating new work. It can be distinguished from reproductions or derivative works. This is originality. But novelty is not originality. Novelty is originality, but originality doesn't mean novel. An original work is that not received from others, nor copied from or based upon the works of others. At the same time, avoid unnecessarily invention. Kadang-kadang kita boleh buat invention yang macam-macam. Kita tambah baik atau kita create something itu, tapi doesn't mean it really need by others. Or kadang-kadang, for example, lampu. Kalau you ubah sikit, this lampu, then you ubah your casing, that is the invention. But actually, it doesn't mean people perlukan. Sometimes it will incur cost. So, it's not necessarily lah. In law, originality has become an important legal concept with respect to intellectual property, where creativity and invention have manifest as copyrightable works. In scientific world, these conceptions are different from that in fashion. The normal that scientific claims and PhD thesis contribute something new. So this is what we talk about PhD and about the masters. Okay, where is novelty in research process? What is research? Is novelty. It's about new observation, new methodology, new elements, and many more. It's about quality of new, original, and unusual in the research. This is novelty. Later, I'll show you the comparison table. Some example, which is very good for us to review and to understand more. Okay, research novelty is a core of every research. Most time, it is not possible for every research topic to be 100% novel. Okay, it's very, very, very difficult. Okay, I tell you my example, the truth about my PhD students. I have one PhD student. They did on the breast cancer detection. UWB microwave imaging. During the viva, we had a problem. Where suddenly we noticed that the current work actually has been overlapping with the other works. So that is something that I really, really learned in my life. Between your student and your supervision, your supervisor, between student and supervisor, you must be truthfully, must discuss truthfully and must have a good trust. For example, when the supervisor tanya, macam mana ni dah check, already check or not? So is there any other works has been carried on related to this work? So you must be very truthfully. Otherwise, this thing will happen. This thing is very, 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 very important between the student and supervisor. The communication. Don't ever break down. So the problem happened when something wrong, the communication between this, and suddenly during the viva, and the panel said, oh, I have this paper, which is very, he print the paper, the journal, and then he said, I have this paper, which is quite related to your work. Can you explain more and can you differentiate between your work and his work? So this is related to this one. Because why? He want to find the novelty of my work compared to others' work, because we want to avoid the overlapping. But of course, it will not be 100% novel, at least. But alhamdulillah, fortunately, we managed to convince them, and then we say that we have a different method that we use compared to them, although the result is almost the same. So alhamdulillah, it's manageable. So that is the things. So that is my based on my experience. So please, along the way, if you find something more related, that's why when you do your PhD or your master's, what you have to do, your literature review must be very targeted aim for the PhD work, especially. So we will publish in a good ISR paper, because what we do is during the viva, if something happened, we will say that we already published this work earlier than the other work. So although the viva is a bit late, but we will say, oh, we already published this earlier. Actually, we already secure. So that is the most important thing. So because when they can find it has similarity, then you'll be in the trouble. So that's why the publication is very important to avoid and to secure your novelty, especially when you go to the ISI. The Q1, the Q2 is good. Q3 and Q4 is a bit low lah, but Q1, Q2 is good. Of course, the novelty some overlaps with previously reported researchers. So this is what I said just now. But you must understand, and especially the supervisors must know how to tune a little bit. How to tune, especially during the viva, because the viva your panel will be someone in this field. They know more actually. I honestly will say this: my students, my PhD student, more than me. He know more than me, because he really thoroughly do in this field. My PhD is in the other works, so I master on that. But his work, because he's the one who study on that, of course he know more than me. That's why the good communication between supervisor and students is very important, especially during the viva. Especially during the study, and of course for your viva, score the viva. And then is what the techniques to fulfill the research gaps noticed in previous studies would be the novelty in your research. This is very important. Identification of research gap. This is where you want to find this research gap. Actually, based on your reading, based on your analyzing, based on your citing the other works, especially on the Q1, Q2. That's why I always say to my students, you can have a number of a number of citation references, but you, for example, you have 80. For PhD, easily you need 80 to 120 references. But among all of them, you must have the prominent one. The prominent, sometimes it can just like 8 to 15 papers. This is the good papers. So you must have the prominent. So from this prominent, what you will get actually, you will manage to identify the research gap. But please carefully cite those papers, especially on 5 years back. For example, your expectation, your viva will be this year. So that particular paper must be from 2016, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So otherwise, it's not really valid, because research is moving very fast, especially on this field, especially on engineering, electronics especially, is moving very fast. So you must cite very good papers, and it must be very recent in order for you to find novelty in research. Okay, research gap is something that remains to be done or learned in an area of research. People always talk about research gap, because from this research gap, you can fill in. That is the most important thing. Fill in means your contribution, how you want to fill in. How you want to fill in is your contribution of your work your method, your insight. So that is the things. That is the most important things. That is the research gap. So you must particularly address a gap in a field of study and attempt to fill in missing pieces of information in the reported literatures. No gap identification means no novelty. So it's very simple. The rule of thumb, if no gap, you cannot find any gap for that particular work, means no novelty, because you cannot fill in. But I always believe everything is not perfect. So it must be something that you can insert. Must be something. Either your techniques, either your material, either your tools, your bots, or either your methods. Do I go too far, too fast? Hello, guys.
Okay. Lanjut. Not too fast.
Okay. Sorry, sebab saya, I cannot see people. So I just, because it's online, it's like I talk to myself lah. Kita macam bercakap dengan diri sendiri kan. Okay. Tambahan ini di restoran pula. Okay, research gap analysis. Research gap identified by asking the questions. So untuk kita dapatkan research gap ni, you must do some analysis. And to do analysis, it's always to have the expected question. So you will ask, what is the significance of this research to my work or the broader field? Does the author's argument require more clarification? For example, kalau you cite other papers, you baca the other works, you akan cuba dapatkan. Ada tak author's argument require more clarification? Normally, what we'll see at these particular things is at the conclusion and future work. So dekat situ kita nampak, oh, this work can be expanded. Tapi don't go for conference, because conference is just like for reading is good, but for PhD, for masters, it's not really good. So you must go for masters, PhD, you must go for the ISI paper, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. So from there, you can see more analysis that can be done and more research gap that you can fill in. What issues or question has the author not addressed? These are the things yang perlu you address. Is there a different perspective that I can consider? What other factors could have influenced the result? Okay, is there scope for you to test the findings using more current approach? These are the question yang you perlu isi. That's why kalau kita buat masters, I normally ask my student at least dalam 2 bulan, you must do a good reading, do some good literature review. And for PhD, at least 6 months lah. From 3 to 6 months. You can study, you can baca, and then before that, after that, you will come out dengan your planning. Normally, I will sit down with my students, kita akan plan. From early of your registration, sampailah 3 tahun, kita akan plan. I will do timeline. From here, ni you buat ini, you buat ini, you buat ini, you buat ini. Normally, my PhD student, I will give them problem statement. Easy actually for them. I will give them problem statement and then you thoroughly check is valid or not, and then we go for that. So easy. Rather than for you to find the problem statement, is a bit difficult actually. It's challenging. That's why you perlukan between 3 to 6 bulan. So that is the minimum lah for the PhD. Okay, sorry. Let me drink first. Okay, next. Research gap analysis. A gap might be a lack of understanding about how well a particular instrument works in a certain situation. That is the research gap. Research gap, kadang-kadang when you read, of course, kalau you baca journal, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 even, you cannot understand, because that is the trick. Normally, people yang publish ni, the more complex the journal, the more difficult for you to understand, the more easier to get published. That is the keyword. I mean, that is the rule of thumb lah. For you to publish dalam Q1, Q2. Kalau you buat very simple, very light, you cannot publish dalam Q1, Q2. That's why kalau macam kita, when we want to read, that particular journal, very difficult. For the first time, very difficult. You kena baca banyak kali. Have to really understand. By reading banyak kali, baru you faham. And then bila you faham, you will see or you will find there must be a lack of understanding or something that you can improve. It must be. Tapi of course lah, kalau kita baca paper orang, kita kena baca banyak kali. Even for me also, it's very difficult for me to read and understand. Normally for me, I will go dekat abstract, I read dulu, and then I go for intro, and then I terus ke result and discussion. I tengok apa that, what are the parameters that the work has been achieved. Then from there, baru kita faham. Kita faham the whole story. And when you faham the whole story, then you easily for you to find the research gap. Research gap. A gap could be introducing a new or revised method that needs to be tested. A gap could be the study of new or part of an organism, system or a process. Okay, this is one of the example. My first example to make ourselves easy to understand. How to find the novelty. How to find novelty, you must understand, and how to find the gap analysis, the research gap. So gap statements in research, example one. Okay, this is from Nasrin Sohrabi and his team. Mentioned here, through the efforts of researchers, many DNA testing technologies were created a few years ago. Although these conventional technologies provide the gold standard for laboratory-based DNA diagnostic, they cannot meet the needs of point-of-care clinical diagnostics. The identification of DNA sequence and their sequence discriminations is difficult and time-consuming and has low hybridization efficiency. Okay, from here, what you understand, this is from the paper. You can easily get the paper download. Here, the author signal to us that this is a gap, the research gap. They use the word, they cannot meet the needs and it's difficult and time-consuming and has low hybridization efficiency. So this is a research gap. So from this paper, you can easily understand, oh, this is something that you can improve, something that you can enhance more with your new method, with your new approach. So, but of course, first thing first, what you have to do is do more reading. Okay, this is second papers. It's from Hyunjung Park, 2018. Our previous study was able to detect EGFR mutation using Kelvin probe force microscopy technique with high sensitivity, but the technique could not be applied to in situ detection. The key point of EGFR mutation detection is high sensitivity as well as in situ detection. In this report, we propose a highly sensitive and in situ detection method of EGFR mutation using quartz crystal microbalance and nanoporous structure QCM electrode. Okay, from here, the paper gives him that the technique could not be applied to in situ detection. So it means what? So this is the research gap. So besides, they also emphasize propose a highly sensitive and in situ detection method. So this is the future work that this paper already highlighted for you to explore. But of course, other people also, other students, other PhD students also, other master students also, is reading this work. So you must be the first person to explore on this, to go for this one. So that's why when you already achieve or manage to secure the target, please, before you graduate or please before you go to Viva, please publish in a good Q paper, in good ISI paper. So that during the Viva, you can easily say, oh, this is, I already locked this work. I already locked this work. This is my method. It says it has been reviewed, because the Q paper, the good Q paper, the reviewer is coming from all over the world and is, of course, is the very professional and a prominent guy in that particular field. So that's why for even for my plus one, They reviewed my work 2 times. Even the last one, the associate editor asked very tricky question. But alhamdulillah, we managed to secure to tackle that, and it's been published lah. It's been accepted and going to publish. So that is the challenge. Even before that, I published in IEEE Access. Same thing, 3 times review. It's very, very thorough. Even the most difficult one is the MDPI census, where when we sending there, I have 2 papers there, collaboration with the University of Kebangsaan Malaysia. It really give our headache. The first paper is okay, but the second one, the reviewer is very thorough. So this is showing what? This shows that if your PhD or your master's work can be published in a Q paper, a good Q papers, so the reviewer for your PhD cannot say actually more. Actually, they must accept this is actually has some weight or some contribution, of course, and easily for you to get pass in your viva. That's very important. Research gap analysis, research novelty. Research novelty is the identification and fulfillment of research gap in the field of study. Commonly, research novelty can be identified in the last paragraph. This is all the keywords that you can find. The purpose of the study is, in this study, we investigated. Therefore, the goal of the study is dot, 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 dot. So, all is stated there. But as I said to you, the ISI paper is very difficult to understand. Why? Because, of course, if your paper is too lenient, too relaxed, cannot be accepted. So, the more complex your paper, the more easy for you to get accepted in the top queue. So that is the challenge. So this shows the gap analysis, the search gap that you can fill in. Of course, no work is idle. There must be some improvement that you can contribute. Okay, another work. This is my student's work. One of them. This is normally what we will do. Even for Viva, for proposal defense, for pre-Viva, we will do this. This is what we call as this is normally we will do the previous work. So we will do 1, 2, and 3. Of course, as I said, you can have many references, 80 to 120, but the most prominent one is the one that you really cite, especially on your technical things, especially on technical. Same to me, my PhD work, I have nearly 8 to 10 papers, good papers that really related to my work, where I can easily say my work is better than this 8 to 10 works, to 10 papers. So for example, like this work, we cite this paper, this paper, and we see what is the feeding methods or switching type. Either they use the real switch or the proof of concept switch. The complexity, how many switches they use, the achievement, the parameters, performance, how many angles that they can achieve. So like this one, they can only achieve 30, but they use 20 switches. For example, like this one, they can only manage achieve 38, and the gain is low, and only has 3 directions, but the complexity is very low, which is very good. And this one also, beside the other papers, and what we see, either they are using the real switch or not, how many angles there has been achieved, 40 and 3 directions, and then how many switches and everything. This is a thorough discussion, a thorough review that you must did before you know what you want to achieve. This is from here, what you will understand is the problem statement. Oh, now you know. Okay, this work introduced many switches. The maximum they can achieve 40. So like this one, they use 20. The minimum is 2. But this one, they can achieve 40. So easily what you can do is, what you can set for your contribution, your maximum tilt angle must be more than 40. the gain or the gain must be more than 8, and the switches at least maximum is 4. So that is the challenge. And one more, don't use proof of concept, use real switch. So this will be your target, your chief. That's why normally for me, I will write design spec. I will ask my student, please write your design spec and your targeted work spec. What you want to achieve? What parameter actually you want to achieve? How much? So these are the things. But all these can be written or can be set after you thoroughly review others' work. A good paper. This is all generics. Okay, for example, like this one. This work. This is my PhD student talk about angle of arrival estimation system for radiation pattern reconfigurable antenna with a membership function. It uses fuzzy membership function. So from these all journals that has been that we cite, we can easily say the drawback is no signal processing algorithm. It has a limited access point, AE point, sorry. High complexity because more bots, more electronic things, no signal, no algorithm, manual configuration, high complexity, no signal processing algorithm. Like this one, you can go, although it can go 12 angle, but no signal processing algorithm, no AI. But our work, what we introduced actually, we have the modified Gaussian membership function, which is more towards AI. And then we have the radiation pattern reconfigurable antenna on the top, integrate between the antenna as well as the AI things. So like this one, they don't have the signal processing. So based on your reading, you can tune and set, oh, this is what you want to achieve. Like this one, we managed to get 15 directions. Like this one, the maximum is 12. But for this work, our work, we managed to secure 15 directions. But I don't share here. What I want to share is more on the comparison on the previous work. This is the table of comparison table of previous work. It's very, very, very important. Okay, like this is another work of my students. He did study on the feed forward back propagation. So it's algorithm also. We have the what we call the training set. We have the testing set. So it's AI. So what we study actually, we want to achieve the result of accuracy. So from this, we want to understand what actually the results of each author based on their approach. Their approach. Normally, of course, they use the NB, Knife, Bayes, DCA, SVM. SVM is the most popular one. Sometimes they say it's obsolete. But the achievement is not SVM, LDA, but they have two approach, two methods. This one, they have three parameters, three results that they are focused on. So like this one, the other works, they focus on BPNN, 93, SVM, LDA, how much. So when you already have all these targets, you can easily set your goal. You can easily set your goal. That is the novelty. Like this one, what they can detect actually based on the tumor, the type of the tumor. How to detect? It's based on this. Type means either malignant or either benign or malignant. They have two types. Resistance and size, they can detect two. Sama ada tumor ada atau tidak, dan juga dari segi size. Kalau tengok dari sini, dia hanya resistant. Kalau tengok ni, resistant dan location. Sama ada atau tidak, ataupun lokasi dekat mana. Sebab this is on the breast. Because you're talking about a breast cancer detection. This is among the hot topic because in Malaysia, I think same I think in Indonesia, it put as among the highest, what they call the most critical disease lah, the most critical problem to the ladies lah, especially. So this is the things that you can see, the parameter that they focus on. So apa yang you boleh buat? I give here, if you can do another detection for your PhD work. You can take up as a PhD. You can check ataupun guna other methods, but you focus on assistance sama ada ada tidak tumor. Kedua, you can do location dekat mana. Location tu can be like 3D, like this one kita kita letak dalam 3D, so we can know the X, Y, Z axis. So later you can cite my paper about this. So kalau untuk future work of this work, you integrate, you guna assistant, ada tak ada, location dekat mana, X, Y, Z tu. And then the third one is the size. So you combine these three, it can be one PhD work. Because dekat sini, none has worked out on that. Paling maksimum pun dua, assistant size, assistant location. But kalau you can buat assistant, location, size, then it will be very, very, very good and can be novel lah. Novel for the PhD work. But of course, you kena cite lah the latest one. This is yang lama. You have to cite the latest one. Okay, this is another thing. So I just want to show you here. This is some example. Whatever topics, whatever works, whatever research that you want to focus on, the comparison table you must do. Like this work, apa yang my student buat, kita tengok inductive types, optical, capacitive, acoustic. This is about heart rate lah. Sorry, heart problem. Kita nak charge rechargeable pacemaker system from outside, from luar daripada body. So no need to do the surgery things to ganti the existing battery and so on. So kalau kita tengok sini, kita do a lot of analysis. We compare, we buat the advantage and disadvantage and the remarks. The remark is some notes lah related to this. So from these two, you can see that apa lagi yang kita boleh buat. Then we come out as a integration. Integration between acoustic and inductive. So it's none people has work out on this at that particular time lah. So now mungkin dah ada. So you kena do more studies from there. Hybrid, you combine inductive and capacitive. Of course, you will get more better results lah. Like this one. This one they claim as a combination, but it's not really combination lah. It's like two approach, two methods, one after another. So it's not a hybrid system, but they claim as hybrid. Okay, this is another example. Another example. Kita really do thorough. We check on this paper. Kita tengok how many things, how other. This is masterwork lah. Masterworks, and kita tengok and see how, what are the things, what are lagi, apa lagi yang boleh kita innovate, yang kita tambah baik. That it will be the innovation. So your future is created by what you do today. So this is will be my last slide. So your future actually is created by what you do today, but actually it's not today. It's about now. So please, before I conclude, you must do understand originality is a novelty. Sorry, novelty of course is a original, but original doesn't mean novel. And novel is more related to the innovation. Is something enhancement or improvement. So novelty is about research, how you want to find the research gap. The comparison, after you do a comparison of previous work, of the previous work based on the ISI paper, good ISI paper, Q1, Q2, 3 and 4 is so good. Three and 4 is also okay, 1 and 2 is good. So based on this comparison, you will come up with the table. This table. From this table, you can easily find your research gap, as well as you will know what you want to fill in. That is very, very, very important. So please bear in mind, novelty is about contribution. If you cannot give your contribution, especially on your PhD work, you will be in trouble. So it's very easy. It's like this. It's like a plate. I always say to my students, this is like a plate. Hopefully you can see. It's like a plate. When you do study, you can easily find the, what do you call, the border, the barrier. The barrier. Oh, I read this, I read that. Since I told you just now, prominent this. And then you can easily get the border. Oh, the other word already done until this part. So what you will do, you will contribute a little bit. It doesn't mean you have to contribute so big, so many. No, as long as you can contribute, so it will go over this barrier, then there is your contribution. People will not ask or say, oh, you must be 50%. No, same like macam tadi, same like breast cancer detection. For example, they use this method, they achieve 80% out of the hard work. As long as you can contribute at least 82% or 83% with the other method, it's fine enough. Sometimes the percent is not so so high, maybe like slightly 81. It's fine enough as long as you use other methods. It shows that with the other methods also you can achieve this method. But of course, you must have the advantage of the proposed work. So that is very, very, very important. So that is all about novelty and research. So please enjoy for those who want, who's still doing the S2, S3. Please proceed. InshaAllah, everything will go smoothly. Please have a good communication dengan between you as a student as well as the supervisors. Same for those, for you young supervisors. Then you have your students. The communication also must be very, very good. For me and my students, so we have very good communication just to avoid anything happen. Because based on my experience yang tadi tu, so now I be more particular lah. I be more careful. And I will keep the good relationship between me and the students. Because anything happen to the driver, it's not only about the student. It's about the supervisor also. The failure of the supervisor to supervise. So that's why I always advise to the student, for those who want to further study, please find a good supervisor. Because sebelum you sambung, your choice. You have the, you have the say. But when you already register, you have the supervisor, and you have to follow the supervisor. Okay. So I think that's all from me. Thank you very much, Robby. And yes. Pak Nusran, Assalamualaikum. And if you have any question, boleh tanyalah.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih Dr. Muzamil atas presentasinya mengenai to find novelty in research. Novelty pasti original. Original belum tentu novelty.
Novel.
Okay, novelty, it's about innovation, correct?
Betul.
Okay. So, Bapak Ibu, kalau ada yang mau bertanya, dipersilakan. Silakan ngomong dalam bahasa Indonesia saja. Karena Dr. Muzamil ini sudah sering ke Medan, jadi bahasa Indonesia cukup ancar gitu.
Boleh. Betul, Pak.
Silakan Bapak Ibu yang mau bertanya, langsung silakan bertanya saja, aktifkan speaker. Dan saya juga sudah ada nemu beberapa pertanyaan di kolom chatting, nanti saya baca. Tapi Kak, saya prioritaskan yang mau bertanya langsung, silakan Bapak Ibu. Terutama ini yang lagi studi S3 atau juga lagi riset yang dapat hibah-hibah dari institusinya ataupun yang dari kementerian IT atau Ristek. Silakan Bapak Ibu, saya kasih waktu. Silakan langsung aja Bapak Ibu yang bertanya. Silakan Pak Ang Darmawan.
Oh iya, terima kasih Pak. Mau tanya gini Prof, mungkin penjelasannya kurang bisa saya tangkap gitu loh. Karena mungkin banyak menggunakan bahasa Inggris gitu. Tapi gini, saya setuju nggak Profesor dengan statement saya? Jadi saya pernah ikut pelatihan novelty dan originality. Kalau originality itu, dia tuh berbeda dengan sebelumnya. Tapi kalau novelty itu harus ada perbaikan gitu, sehingga perbaikan dari sebelumnya gitu. Itu simpelnya gitu. Apakah seperti itu? Kemudian yang kedua, untuk menemukan gap itu, apakah seperti yang Profesor katakan tadi perlu sekitar 4 atau 6 bulan untuk menyelami gap, kemudian originalitinya di mana gitu. Seperti itu. Kemudian apa ada trik khusus untuk menemukan gap dan originality tadi yang simple untuk diterapkan? Itu aja Prof. Terima kasih.
Oke, kita jawab okay, dulu. Pak. Silakan Pak Muzamil.
Okey Pak, berkenaan dengan original dengan novelty, betul. Memang macam tu. Macam Bapak sebut tadi, original pastinya novel pastinya original. Original belum tentu novel. Sebab original ni you buat sikit itu already sudah jadi original. Tapi yeah. Novel actually kena contribute kepada method dan sebagainya, kepada technical things. Yang kedua,
yang kedua apa tadi Pak Darmawan? Bisa diulangin?
Saya kena tulis lah.
Yang kedua Darmawan. Lupa Pak.
Yang kedua itu ditanya mengenai trik ya tadi Pak ya, trik.
Ya, triknya.
Oh, trik. Oh, ya ya. Saya tak siap saya yang kedua.
Menemukan novelty.
Apa perlu ya. Gini? Apa perlu seperti Pak tadi katakan sekitar 6 atau sampai 6 bulan gitu untuk menyelami dalamannya ini.
Okey, sebagai contoh, dia tergantung kepada supervisor, Pak. Tergantung pada supervisor. Macam saya, selalunya saya sudah ada saya punya problem statement. Saya akan bagi student, ini problem statement saya. You follow ini, you buat ini, you akan dapat your PhD, your ability, your contribution. Ada setengah supervisor, dia tak ada problem statement lagi. So itu yang perlukan 3 ke 6 bulan untuk study, untuk fahamkan. Kadang-kadang ada supervisor, dia buat something yang new untuk dia, yang di luar pemahaman. Itu yang paling penting, yang paling pening, Pak. Jadi bila dia buat something yang di luar pemahaman kemampuannya, jadi dia perlu lebih banyak penelitian. Jadi itu yang butuh 3 ke 6 bulan.
Ya. Saya gini Pak, ikut pelatihan dari University Malaysia Perlis juga minggu kemarin 7 hari turnitin gitu, diminta membuat apa namanya metriknya gitu loh, metriknya terus ya itu mungkin yang membuat lama gitu, sampai originalitasnya gimana gitu, kontributnya gimana. Itu yang membuat lama. Dari Intas Perlis juga, Malaysia Perlis juga.
Itulah Pak, dia tergantung kepada supervisor.
Oh gitu.
Di mana-mana sebab universiti berbeza-beza school of thought lah, dia panggil school of thought. Kalau supervisor pun ada yang macam-macam ragam, Pak. Ada yang supervisor okay, ada yang supervisor kurang kan dan sebagainya. Sebab itu komunikasi antara student dengan supervisor itu penting. Itu yang saya bilang dari awal, pemilihan student terhadap supervisor tu sangat penting. Sebelum mau sambung kan, nak pilih itu, kena pilih yang betul-betul. Kalau dapat yang susah, yang kurang guide, then very very problem. Bukan saya nak takutkan Pak, tapi begitulah. Jadi kalau yang kurang membantu, supervisor yang kurang membantu ini perlu penelitian yang lebih. Perlu 4 hingga 6 bulan untuk study, untuk fahamkan. Sebab itulah mungkin juga ada supervisor yang dia baru nak explore something new bidang. Jadi dia perlu lebih banyak masa.
Betul. Ya. Kalau misalnya ini juga melanjut Pak Kawan. Misalnya ini juga berlaku untuk research grant, dokter ya?
Ya, betul.
Jadi seandainya case-nya itu adalah kita membuat sebuah research yang dapat grant, berarti novelty dari research itu juga harus banyak membaca literatur pastinya, dokter ya?
Ya, betul.
Baru kita buat apa gap, research gap dari yang sudah pernah ada, kemudian apa yang mau kita teliti, gitu dokter.
Okay. Sayang saya Pak, dalam grant, bila tulis grant, kadang-kadang grant ini dia tak perlu very tara punya citation dan sebagainya. Problem statement dia very simple. Kadang-kadang grant ni lebih kepada apa yang you nak capai, macam mana you nak buat itu belum tentu dan belum semestinya harus solid. Tetapi PhD, you memang kena cari betul-betul research gap dan apa method yang you nak pakai dan you nak achieve. Dia agak berbeza sebab mostly grant ni saya tengok dia berbeza lah. Tapi kedua-duanya memerlukan study literature review yang tinggi. Itu yang saya boleh highlight lah.
Ada lagi pertanyaan Pak Darmawan?
Ya, ini apa Prof mau tanya apa namanya?
Apa Halo, Pak? putus. Pak Darmawan.
Oh iya, iya. Iya Pak, silakan. Silakan dilanjutkan.
Oh iya.
Saya ini hasil... apa bedanya gini, Prof? Jadi untuk kedalamannya itu bedanya PhD, S2 sama S1 itu apa? Magister, PhD, tentang kedalaman risetnya dan seperti apa level novelty dan originality-nya untuk level, apa untuk membedakan PhD, Magister, and PhD?
Level, oh, kalau level lah nih. Saya suka gambar ini. Sekejap ya. Ini Pak, kalau untuk master cukup sekadar yang ini, yang di lorek ini. Master, master ni kalau bapak buat sistem, jadi knowledge agak besar, tapi depth ni kurang, kurang analisis yang mendalam. Tapi PhD ini harus di study very thorough. Macam saya sebut tadi, kalau bapak buat IoT sistem. Sebenarnya IoT system itu is a system, satu besar benda yang yang besar. Contoh smart attendance system.
Halo, Dr. Muzamil. Jaringannya mungkin bermasalah. Kita tunggu sebentar ya Pak Termawan.
Oke, terima kasih.
Mungkin jaringan Dr. Muzamil lagi down.
Hello Pak Robi, dengar? Oh,
dengar, dengar. Okey, okey.
Silakan.
Okey. Pak, ni nampak skrin eh?
Nampak, nampak, nampak.
Nampak, okey. Maksud saya tadi Pak, kalau macam kita buat sistem tadi, kita guna banyak knowledge. Tapi untuk PhD, mungkin kita fokus on security. Satu bidang saja. Itu yang baru dia boleh claim sebagai PhD. Dan depth of knowledge kena dalam Pak. Kena very thorough. Sebab itu macam bidang saya pun, saya hanya tahu satu saja. Saya tahu ini saja. Saya yang lain, saya harus explore. Sebab itu saya minta kadang-kadang student saya untuk explore dan sebagainya. Nampak Pak? Itu beza. Masters beza dengan PhD.
Screennya tidak nampak, Doktor.
Tak nampak Pak?
Screen tidak nampak.
Oh, siap, siap. Sekejap ya. Tadi dia terputus. Ini. Okay. Nampak eh? Maksudnya okay,
okay.
Pak?
Nampak, PhD. Nampak.
Ini master. PhD harus dalam lagi Pak. Kedalaman ilmu itu harus dalam lagi. Jadi bapak akan faham kalau contoh orang yang bidang sensors, dia mungkin expert dalam sensors je. Kalau tanya dia yang lain-lain, mungkin dia tak boleh, tak, kuranglah dia kurang. Jadi itu beza master. Beza PhD. Sebab itu Pak.
Harus fokus di satu titik ini, Prof ya. Harus ya, fokus di satu.
Iya. Harus gitu. Sebab itu sebagai supervisor, dia mesti tahu untuk kata, okay, cukup. Ini your master, cukup. Okay, ini cukup untuk PhD. Stop. Boleh hantar buat report, hantar thesis. Sebab itu penting untuk cari supervisor yang boleh cakap, okay, ini cukup, submit. So, whatever nanti, insyaAllah, okay, tak ada masalah. Dia sudah dapat projek. Tapi kalau supervisor yang tidak mampu macam tu, tak mampu untuk nilai, itu yang problem, Pak. Sebab itu supervisor harus ada team juga. Macam saya, saya ada team. Kawan-kawan yang bantu. Kadang-kadang kita kurang mahir, kita minta. Sebab tu ada co-supervisor satu, co-supervisor dua. Kita ada field supervisor dekat universiti lain untuk bantu. Dia harus teamwork, Pak. Baru boleh sukses. Untuk guide. Macam selalu student saya yang ni, kita memang akan sit down sekali dengan co-supervisor untuk tolong sama-sama. Itu penting, Pak. Inilah insyaAllah. Itu saja yang saya faham, Pak. Ini saya punya drawing lah yang saya faham pasal master dengan PhD. Okay. My own understanding.
Yeah. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Prof.
Okay.
Thank you, Pak. Pertanyaan berikutnya dari Pak Rusen Magayang, silakan Pak. Pak Rusen. Halo Pak. Halo. Halo Pak Rusen, mungkin Pak Rusen yang enggak ada. Baru ada pertanyaan juga dari Pak Pak Jabar, Pak Abdul Jabar, silakan Pak.
Oh. Mesti Harapan Medan.
Ya, Pak Abdul Jabar.
Unhar, Unhar.
Mana Pak Abdul Jabar ini? Pak Abdul Jabar. Oke, mungkin malu dia tuh, dokter. Oh, saya baca, okay. Saya baca pertanyaan dari kolom chat saja. Kalau perbedaan riset itu berada pada lokasi dan waktu, bagaimana menulis riset skip yang tepat? So, dia punya lokasi A dengan metode A, kemudian lokasinya ini diganti jadi lokasi B, tapi dengan metode A tersebut. Apakah memungkinkan bisa dilakukan ataukah bisa diterapkan itu menjadi sebuah novelty? Ini pertanyaan dari Pak Muhammad Zainal. Apakah ada Pak Muhammad Zainal di sini? Pak Muhammad Zainal Mutakin.
Okey Pak, saya jawab Pak. Dia tergantung Pak. Contoh, kalau sekarang Bapak study on rain something, on propagation, it's about rain punya effect. Kalau di Malaysia, lokasi di Malaysia pasti berbeza berbanding di Indonesia. So kalau berubah lokasi, itu tak ada masalah. Sudah pasti approach-nya akan jadi berbeza. Contoh kalau kita study on rain, kan? Rain effect towards signal propagation. So hujan di Malaysia lain, hujan di Indonesia lain. So kalau guna teknik dibawa tukar lokasi, tak ada masalah. Sebab sudah pasti dia akan ada perubahan sedikit dari segi method. Berubah lokasi pasti akan ada perubahan. Sama juga kalau bapak buat measurement dalam lab, bapak bawa measurement di luar, on field, testing, pasti berbeza. Kalau bapak buat satu sistem, IoT sistem agriculture dalam satu greenhouse, bapak tanam the same pokok, same crops, tanaman itu bapak bawa di luar, pasti methodnya lain. Tak ada masalah. Okay, kalau guna method yang berbeza, pasti tak ada masalah. Itu lebih baik. Kita mungkin nak capai benda yang sama. Contoh breast cancer detection.
Ya. Tidak, itu fungsinya dia hanya sebagai breast. Seleksi berkas dulu. Ya.
Breast cancer detection. Halo? Nah. Halo? Mohon maaf.
Kalau breast cancer detection, kita nak study benda yang sama. Tetapi method pasti berbeza. Method saya lain, method Robi lain, method Pak Misran lain. Tak ada masalah. Benda yang sama juga. So, tak ada masalah Robi. Okay. Tak ada masalah Pak Marwan.
Oh, ya. Muhammad Mutakin.
Pak Mutakin.
Muhammad Zainal Mutakin. So, tidak masalah dia dokter ya. Dia lokasi berbeda, tapi dengan metode yang sama ya.
Ya. Yeah. Sebab saya percaya pasti dia method akan jadi lain. Akan berubah sikit.
Menyesuaikan dengan kondisi lokasi.
Ya.
Bukannya nggak boleh program itu.
Oke. Saya muncul ada pertanyaan lagi dari Ibu Yeni. How can we know before we start to do that our script is novelty research script? Ini Bu Yeni ini. Bu Yeni. Halo Bu Yeni. Halo. Yeni.
Halo.
Ah, silakan Bu, ditanya aja langsung.
Oke,
Bahasa Indonesia aja Bu, enggak apa-apa.
Ya, ya.
Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, tadi kan saya tanya gimana kita bisa tahu bahwa sebelum kita menulis nanti tulisan kita itu memang novelty gitu. Jadi kan biasanya mungkin ada, karena kan saya posisinya di West Aceh, Aceh Barat gitu Pak ya. Di daerah agak pelosok sedikit lah istilahnya ya. jadi kan agak susah untuk mengetahui bahwa my script is novelty gitu.
Oh, okay.
Script ini apa Bu? Coding atau apa Bu?
Tulisan.
Oh.
Tulisan yang akan saya ini kan gitu.
Publish untuk risetnya.
Publish,
yes. Ibu, gini. Satu kita boleh refer IEEE Explore. Yang selalu saya refer lah IEEE Explore. Dalam tu ada banyak papers which is kita boleh compare kita punya work dengan other people punya work. Yang kedua, dalam paper dekat bahagian introduction, kita akan tulis dalam normally kalau kita tengok journal yang Q1, Q2 ni, Q3, Q4. Dia dekat intro tu dia akan tulis previous work punya kerja, apa yang previous work capai dan apa yang you akan contribute. Contoh contoh result mutual coupling effect -21. So your focus akan lebih pada tu. Kalau contoh dekat situ dia punya untuk detect cancer tadi, parameter accuracy mungkin dalam 80%. So dekat situ you dah mention. Maksudnya your work kat dalam nanti akan better daripada orang lain. Cuma ada triknya Ibu. Ada triknya bila kita tulis itu, janganlah kita ambil journal yang terlalu high end, yang terlalu power sangat, yang terlalu hebat. Sebab nanti bila kita nak tunjuk kata kita ada sedikit achievement, susah. Yang penting dalam paper kena ada compare dengan previous work. Tapi kan paper banyak, boleh pilih yang mana yang mungkin kurang daripada kita, supaya bila orang, bila reviewer baca, dia akan tahu oh kita punya better than others. Sebab yang others tu janganlah ambil yang terlalu hebat, ambil yang agak-agak yang kita boleh lawan, baru ada kontribusi. Sama macam PhD. Kita study kan, untuk dapat contribution, janganlah ambil yang terlalu mantap sangatlah. Ya. Okay. Tapi harus buat banyak review lah.
Jadi okay. Bu Yeni bidang apa Bu?
Saya manajemen pendidikan Islam, Pak.
Manajemen pendidikan Islam. Jadi kalau cari referensinya kalau tadi Dr. Muzamil itu dia cari di IT. Jadi kalau kayak Ibu cari itu dari Science Direct, banyak Ibu dari pendidikan, manajemen,
atau ya? Emerald.
Ya,
dari jurnal-jurnal Science Direct atau Emerald. Kemudian Ibu misalnya mungkin masuk ke Pak Muzamil itu jika buat paper, buat tulisan, jangan carinya dari yang Q1 berimpact factor, jangan, cari aja artikel-artikel literatur review yang dari Q3 atau Q2. Yang artinya bisa ibu buat juga perbedaannya itu compare itu nggak terlalu tinggi, jadi artikel ibu itu juga mudah accept-nya gitu. Itu
maksudnya. Ya, betul.
Makasih Pak.
Oke, sama-sama Ibu. Nah, pertanyaan berikutnya dari Pak Muhammad Fatoni. Mana Pak Muhammad Fatoni? Silakan Pak. Pak Muhammad Fatoni. Pak Muhammad Fatoni. Oh, mix errors.
Okay.
How to find a good supervisor? Ini dengan novelty research.
Okay. Supervisors ni harus melalui kenalan-kenalan, mungkin datang bincang dulu, sembang, discuss, jumpa dulu, baru boleh nilai. Kalau tidak, susah. Memang banyak pengalaman. Kalau contoh kawan-kawan pun ramai juga mungkin pergi, ada yang pergi UK last kali balik tak habis sebab supervisors. Kan, I think kawan-kawan lain, mungkin Pak Ruby pun biasa kan dengar orang pergi tengok-tengok tak habis, sudah balik sebab supervisors kan. So itulah, pemilihan sangat penting. So macam kita dekat, so senang untuk datang tengok dulu, sembang. Sekarang kita sudah ada online kan, kita boleh tengok, bincang. Kalau rasa macam okay, sudah jatuh hati nak buat, okay buat. Jangan nanti menyesal sebab sambung lama, 3 tahun. Tak mungkinlah nanti sudah 2 tahun tiba-tiba mau tukar. Tambah lagi. Setahun ni akan jadi tambah lagi 2. So rugi. 5 tahun. So harus pilih dari awal. Jadi susah juga. Kadang-kadang yang terlalu expert, yang terlalu hebat, expectation ni tinggi. expectation tinggi, jadi agak susah sedikit. Contoh contoh kalau macam di Malaysia, kita ada research university. Kita ada Universiti Melaya contoh. Dia punya KPI memang tinggi. KPI tinggi. Untuk seorang PhD, dia mesti Q1 sebelum grad. So, dia wajib. Memang wajib. So, syarat-syarat ni pun penting juga. Kalau di UNIMAP, kita belum ada lagi lah. So, agak ni. Agak-agak masih boleh dirunding lah. So, begitu. Pemilihan sangat penting.
UNIMAP enak. Saya sudah merasakan.
Terima kasih, Rabi.
Oke, pertanyaan berikutnya. Nah, ini dari Pak Dokter nih, Pak Agung nih. Ini dari Bali nih, Dokter Musamil, Pak Agung.
Okay.
Kawan saya nih. Monggo Pak Agung, ngomong saja.
Ya, silakan Pak Agung.
Oke. Okay. Thank you Pak siapa? Pak Musamil, Pak. Ya, Pak Robi, makasih banyak. Senang bertemu. Ya, sini ya. Saya belum dokter, Pak. Masih studi, Pak.
Oh, tak apa, Pak. Tak apa.
Ya. My question is, what about conceptual paper, Pak? Conceptual paper. Because my current research is only proposed research. Like I perform the hypothesis, the proposition, but the reviewer still need more discussion and more results. It's not fit about my focus area. What about what should we do about the reviewer? What should we do? What about the answer of reviewer's comment like that? Thank you.
Okay, Pak. Pengalaman saya sendiri, Pak. Pemilihan journal pun sangat penting. Kadang-kadang kita punya work ni, contoh. Saya pernah, yang plus one tu saya sudah hantar di IEEE SS. Tapi reject. Tapi bila hantar ke plus one, accept. Maksudnya dia tergantung. Tergantung bidang itu. Macam ada satu lagi, saya hantar ke plus one, reject. Tetapi saya hantar ke applied physics, accept. So dia tergantung reviewernya, Pak. Selalunya memang kita akan berubah-ubah. Saya pernah kerja tu, bila saya hantar, journal tu minta saya measure semula. Tambah lagi measurement. So memang kita tak boleh buat. Saya bagi tahu dia, minta maaf, saya pun tak ada equipment. And then saya terpaksa withdraw. It's normal, Pak. Saya withdraw, saya hantar tempat lain. So alhamdulillah accepted juga. So tergantung, dia memang berbeza-beza, Pak. Tambahan pula associate editor is different. It's different. Kalau associate editor from UK, memang particularly from Europe guy, normally tough lah. But sometimes kalau from Pakistan, from Chinese, dia agak okay. Even kalau associate editor from Japan ke apa, dia punya English not really kan. So dia okay je. So depends, very subjective. Ini memang sangat subjective.
Yeah, and the editor decision is I should resubmit to review. There's not rejected or resubmit review in 7 days. So, ya gimana saya harus menjawab revisinya mereka. And the journal, the focus and scope in the journal is accepted for conceptual paper. Accepted conceptual paper. Nah, terus kemudian di reviewernya itu minta result and discussionnya mana. Nah, ini kan agak nggak match gitu antara reviewer sama fit scopus scope jurnalnya sendiri gitu, Pak.
Agung, Pak. Pak Asya, conceptual research ya. Propose ya.
Ya, propose research, ya.
Tapi memang normal, Pak. Selalu macam tu. Contoh macam yang saya punya paper tu, dia accept review paper. Tapi kena reject juga. Dia minta extra work. So kami tak boleh buat and then kita surrender. It's normal, Pak. Reject and accept ni is asam garam dalam publication. InsyaAllah kadang-kadang kita hantar dekat journal yang sama, tapi bila dapat reviewer yang berbeza, accept. Dia kan? Itu subjective, Pak. Memang susah. Saya biasa jadi reviewer, selalunya saya accept. Cuma paling tidak kita akan bagi major untuk dia improve, itu saja. So berbeda lah.
Jadi saya maju aja ya Pak ya?
Ya ya, harus maju.
Aja sesuai ini.
Ya Pak, okay. harus. Yang penting ya. Don't give up Pak. Don't give up.
Thank you Pak, thank you. Sukses.
Okay. Sukses.
Oke, Bapak Ibu lagi siapa silakan yang mau bertanya bisa aktifkan mic langsung bertanya atau raise hand. Silakan. Kita masih ada waktu sedikit lagi. Ada lagi Bapak Ibu? Oh, satu lagi. Bagaimana mengetahui novelty yang kita temukan itu benar-benar original dan berbobot? Belum pernah diteliti oleh orang lain sebelum kita discuss ke supervisor.
Ah, okay. Sebab itu dalam kita buat table of comparison, kita perlu cari jurnal yang mantap. Jurnal Q1, Q2 untuk pastikan dan juga mesti recent, mesti terbaru. So at least 5 tahun ke belakang. Jangan ambil lama sangat, 8 tahun, 10 tahun, jangan. Ambil 5 tahun ke belakang. So based on itu, kita buat comparison. Pada masa itu, itulah. Kalau kita sudah review banyak dan pada masa itu, itulah yang terbaik. Dan itulah contribution yang kita boleh contribute. Tetapi along the way, macam saya kata tadi, kalau orang lain sudah publish, itu problem juga. Jadi harusnya kita publish dulu. Kita publish dulu, kita secure dulu. Dia memang susah sebab kita competition all over the world. So mungkin kawan di Jerman, kawan di France sudah buat. Tapi don't worry sebab selalunya kalau contoh di Malaysia, dia akan tengok di Malaysia sahaja. Jarang dia akan compare atau jumpa dengan yang lain. Tapi kalau kita sudah buat thorough literature review, insyaAllah tak ada masalah. Yang penting komunikasi antara bapa dengan supervisor harus ada. Itu saja. Harus komunikasi dengan baik. Dan itulah Pak, cara review sangat penting. Reference banyak, tak ada masalah, tetapi yang very prominent, yang sangat-sangat dekat dengan kerja kita, yang sangat-sangat berhubung kait, itu mesti ada. Antara 8 hingga 15. Yang ini yang Bapak harus pegang. Itu saja Pak. All the best.
Thank you. Sudah cukup seperti ya. Terima kasih. Ya, silakan Ibu. Ya,
oke.
Okay. Bu Khalidah.
Iya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam.
Terima kasih Dr. Muzammil, luar biasa materinya. Dan terima kasih Pak Robi. Ini tentang disertasi. Disertasi kita itu ada 3 variabel yang dimuat di judul. Lalu ketika kita turunkan pertanyaan penelitiannya juga 3. Yang akan kita tanyakan Dr. Muzammil, apa yang menjadi standar atau ukuran untuk kita menarik novelty dari penelitian kita itu? Ini kan memang library ya dokter ya. Apakah dari 3 variabelnya atau cukup 1 saja? Terima kasih dokter.
Oke, kalau pada saya sekurang-kurangnya harus 2. Sekurang-kurangnya harus 2. Contoh, kalau kita cerita, kalau orang lain sudah buat accuracy, efficiency dengan apa lagi? Mungkin satu lagi loss ke. So at least kurang-kurangnya 2. Sama juga untuk kita punya kerja, kalau yang bahagian engineering, kita mesti ada comparison. Selalunya orang akan buat sama ada it's about formula, algorithm, simulation, satu lagi measurement. 2 dari 3 sudah cukup. Maksudnya kalau kita ada fundamental, kita come out dengan formula, dengan equation, kita compare dengan simulation. Sudah 2 sudah cukup. Ataupun kita ada simulation, kita compare dengan measurement. Sudah cukup. Ada juga kerja yang saya pernah tengok orang buat, dia ada formula fundamental, dia terus buat measurement setup sebab dia tak ada software yang boleh support. So at least 2 daripada 3. Untuk validation. Validation.
Ya. Makasih Dr.
Sama.
Jazakallah khairan.
Amin. Wa iyyakum.
Ya.
Oke, ada lagi Bapak Ibu? Tidak ada? Oke, tidak ada lagi. Oke, terima kasih Dr. Muzamil.
Terima kasih Pak Robi.
Terima kasih sudah sharing sedikit mengenai how to find novelty in research. Ini kegiatan, ini hari yang pertama ini Bapak Ibu. Besok ada kegiatan lagi, workshop sharing-sharing lagi. Ini di oleh Dr. Pak Len. Ini beliau juga dari University Malaysia Perlis. Research metodologi, betul ya Pak Mesran ya? Research metodologi kan?
Ya benar.
Research metodologi. Ya betul Pak Mesran ya?
Oke, benar.
Nah, research metodologi. Jadi silakan juga besok Bapak Ibu yang mau lebih detail lagi mengenai research metodologi boleh ikut. Nanti URL-nya akan kami share. Ya, nanti kami mungkin boleh nanti di-share oleh Pak Mesran. Silakan. Jadi memang 3 hari berturut-turut ini kami di Medan, beberapa kampus dan juga ada namanya forum ingin sharing selalu mengenai penelitian. Nah, kebetulan kami juga di Medan ini juga berkomunikasi baik dengan beberapa universitas dan politeknik di Malaysia. Salah satunya itu adalah University Malaysia Perlis. Karena memang banyak sekali dosen-dosen di Medan ini yang lagi studi PhD di University Malaysia Perlis. Ya, termasuk saya dan beberapa kawan-kawan yang ada dalam forum Zoom ini. Gitu. Nah, mungkin hari ini sesi pertama oleh Dr. Muzamil selesai. Terima kasih banyak Dr. Muzamil atas sharingnya dan terima kasih juga banyak. Terima kasih juga kepada Bapak Ibu yang hadir dari jam 10 hingga jam 12 kurang 15 ini. Dan untuk daftar hadir juga silakan diisi ada di kolom chat. Nanti untuk e-certificate akan dikomunikasikan dengan Pak Mesran. Sekali lagi saya ucapkan terima kasih banyak. Saya akhiri dengan wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Untuk materi Bapak Ibu nanti akan di email oleh panitia. Nanti materi Dr. Muzamil boleh bagi ke saya, Dokter?
Boleh, boleh.
Boleh, oke, thank you. Terima kasih banyak.
Sama.
Oke.
Untuk sertifikat tanggal 7 paling lambat ya Rob ya.
Ya, sertifikat tanggal 7.
Ini lagi proses.
Ada channel YouTube-nya ya, Pak?
Recording, Pak. Nanti kalau mau recording-nya ada di saya, nanti bisa saya nanti Pak Mesran tolong aja nanti di email aja recording ini. Nanti baik, Bapak Ibu semua akan dapat recording-nya. Hasil rekamannya Bapak Ibu.
Oh iya.
Ada nanti